Turkey has developed several advanced unmanned aerial and ground vehicles for military use, including robots. These systems feature autonomous and manual operation modes, advanced weaponry, and real-time data transmission capabilities. They are designed for various missions such as reconnaissance, target destruction, and logistical support. Let's jump right in with Songar. Songar is a low-altitude, unmanned combat aerial vehicle, UAEV, developed by ASIS Guard for the Turkish Armed Forces. It includes a quadrator UAEV, a ground control station, and ground support equipment. It operates in both autonomous and manual flight modes, featuring route planning, autonomous flight, and autonomous return to base in critical battery charge level and data link disconnection situations. It can transmit telemetry data and images simultaneously. Songar has an operational range of approximately 10 kilometers and is equipped with both daylight and infrared cameras. It is fitted with several built-in weapons and can remotely destroy targets. The maximum takeoff weight, when fully equipped and armed, is 45 kilograms. It operates at a height of 400 meters above ground level and a maximum elevation of 2.8 kilometers above mean sea level. The drone is dust resistant, complying with the IP67 standard, and has GPS and global navigation satellite system compatible navigation capability. This system is advantageous because it is low cost, customizable, easy to use, lightweight, and portable by personnel across multiple units. The first Songar drone was delivered to the Turkish Armed Forces in 2020 and integrated into a tactical 4x4 wheeled armored fighting vehicle. In November 2021, it was announced that Songar was being exported to two countries. Songar includes an automatic gun stabilizer, recoil damping, and a tiltable barrel. It features a 10x magnification pilot camera, a gun camera, and a ground control station. The drone can continue its mission with a quickly changeable magazine, requiring no special intervention. Simultaneous missions can be performed with one or multiple drones. The drone conducts aerial reconnaissance, destroys targets, performs post-operative damage assessments, and transmits real-time images. In March 2022, a Songar drone with a laser-guided mini-missile system was tested. It can fire 6 mini-missiles developed by Troy Technology. Intended for use in cross-border and residential areas, the missiles are launched from 550 millimeters long, single-use tubes. Songar with mini-missiles is used to destroy fixed targets, such as unarmored and lightly armored vehicles, buildings, and small structures. Jackal is a small, light, and compact unmanned aerial vehicle designed and developed by British Flyby Technology, Turkish Fly Baulas Technology, and Maxwell Innovation. The Jackal drone, equipped with missiles capable of striking armored vehicles, is approaching its first order. Armed with martlet missiles, which have a warhead weight of 3 kilograms, it can effectively destroy APCs and IFVs. This offers an intriguing solution that could undermine the standard tactics of using attack helicopters. Combining a drone with man pads to counterattack helicopters appears to be an ideal countermeasure against the tactic of helicopters hiding behind terrain. However, with such an anti-aircraft drone, this tactic becomes ineffective. This type of weaponry potentially makes attack helicopters, which can engage targets in a non-line-of-sight mode, seem powerless. Taiwan is the first buyer, having ordered 160 of these UAVs. An agreement has been made between the British company Flyby Technology and Geosat Aerospace and Technology regarding the transfer of technology and the production of 160 UAVs, as announced by the Taiwanese company. The Bayraktar TB2 is a tactical armed UAV system developed and manufactured by Baykar in Turkey. It features a sophisticated design that provides all necessary solutions in one integrated system. The system includes the Bayraktar TB2 armed UAV platform, ground control station, ground data terminal, and trailer modules. Thanks to Baykar's technological expertise, the entire system is produced indigenously. The Bayraktar TB2 is a long-endurance tactical unmanned aerial vehicle, capable of conducting intelligence, surveillance, reconnaissance, and armed attack missions. Its onboard avionics suite, with a triple redundant avionics system, enables fully autonomous taxiing, takeoff, landing, and cruising. The TB2 has proven its efficacy with over 800,000 operational flight hours. Since 2014, it has successfully carried out missions for the Turkish Armed Forces, Gendarmerie, and Turkish National Police. Currently, 257 Bayraktar platforms serve Turkey, Qatar, Ukraine, and Azerbaijan. The Bayraktar TB2 holds Turkish aviation records for endurance and altitude. It is also the first aircraft in its category to be exported abroad. The Baykar real-time imagery transmission system provides real-time image transmission and processing solutions to the defense industry. BGAM allows high-resolution, delay-free live broadcasts to be monitored by multiple users simultaneously. BGAM is a web-based application that enables secure live broadcasts on the network or on tablets via the mobile app. The system automatically stores all transmitted imagery in 30-minute files. While monitoring live imagery, users can take multi-tag notes. Saved tags and labels facilitate searching through archived videos later. Based on these notes, a mission log can be created and exported. For security reasons, the system automatically regenerates temporary passwords to secure access to live and archived imagery. The Kargu 2 is a quadcopter drone built by the Turkish company STM. It uses machine learning algorithms embedded on the platform, enabling it to operate autonomously as well as manually. Unlike the Bayraktar TB2, the Kargu 2 is designed as an anti-personnel weapon capable of selecting and engaging human targets based on machine learning object classification. Although various ammunition options are available, the Kargu 2 detonates an explosive charge close to the target, minimizing collateral damage. Due to these characteristics, humanitarian concerns should focus on the drone's ability to distinguish legitimate military targets from protected civilians and direct its attacks accordingly. The technical difficulties of proportionality assessments when civilian collateral damage is expected are irrelevant unless the Kargu 2 is deployed in heavily populated civilian areas. Weapons that cannot make this distinction or limit their attack effects are already prohibited under customary international law. Commanders and operators must do everything feasible to verify that targets are legitimate military objectives and cancel or suspend an attack if it becomes apparent that the target is not a military objective. The drone's machine learning-based object classification using real-time image processing may help meet the distinction requirement. This is especially true if the system is trained to recognize features common among legitimate military targets, such as uniforms and other visual indicators of military affiliation. The BOGAÇ 6x6 is an unmanned ground vehicle developed by Electroland Defense in Turkey. This vehicle can use the remote-controlled weapon system and can also perform logistical support, equipped operation cargo transportation, gun tower reconnaissance, surveillance, and leading force tasks. Another feature of the BOGAÇ is that it can be equipped for the evacuation of wounded. In a statement made by the company, it is stated that the concept is the first in the world. BOGAÇ will be sent to the injured person in cases where the conflict is ongoing, and it is risky for rescue and medical teams to enter. The BOGAÇ, which can reach a maximum speed of 12 kilometers per hour, can work for 8 hours with the battery and 12 hours with the diesel generator, either autonomously or remote controlled from a distance of 2 miles. The Shadow Rider unmanned ground vehicle has been designed as a force multiplier on the battlefield. It is manufactured by Turkish armored vehicles provider FNSS, a joint venture between Turkish industrial conglomerate Neural and British aerospace and defense firm BAE Systems. The UGV is equipped with an AI-based autonomy kit, decision support systems, a sensor suite, and systems designed for positional and situational awareness. The UGV concept was demonstrated at the International Defense Industry Fair 2019 in Istanbul, while the prototype vehicle was officially unveiled at the August 2021 edition of the exhibition. The vehicle's modular design makes it suitable for various missions and operations in difficult conditions and terrains. The architecture supports the integration of different payloads to support a range of missions, including surveillance and reconnaissance, tactical deception, logistics support, communication relay, fire support, and military evacuation. Shadow Rider has a length of less than 5.5 meters, a width of 3 meters, and a combat weight of 13,500 kilograms. The UGV offers high firepower and incorporates a 360-degree detection system. It features an autonomous control system that meets military standards. Thanks for watching, and make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and put notifications on to stay updated on everything related to AI and robotics.